Good morning, children. Once again, welcome to my class. Today we are in the fourth class. So far we have finished three classes successfully. Hope you have enjoyed all those, and you will also enjoy this lesson. In our previous classes, right from the mineral ore to the extraction of the high reactive metals from their ores, moderate reactive metals from their ores, and today we are going to learn the extraction of the metals which are at the bottom of the activity series. Okay, hope you will pay attention for better understanding. Soon after finishing this class, just try to go through once in your textbook. It will help you for better understanding the concepts you have learned in my class. These two are the topics that are going to be covered in today's class: extraction of low reactive metals and the refinement of crude metals. Okay, let us start the class. Before going to that, as usual, we, on behalf of you and me, I extend my sincere thanks to our DO sir and the secretaries of the both DCV secretaries of the both the districts. Now let us recap the various steps involved the extraction of the metals. Repeatedly, I am just revising before every class so that you can understand, you can memorize, you can recall them perfectly. From ore to concentration of the ore, which contains four steps based on the nature of the ore. After dressing or concentration of the ore, the next stage is extraction of the crude metal from the ore. The extraction is based on the nature of the metal, actually the reactivity nature of the metals. Different methods are used for different nature of the metal in the ore. High reactive metals are extracted in some way, whereas moderately reactive metals are extracted in some other way, like the low reactive metals that we are going to learn today. The first step is reduction of the metal, then the purification or refinement of the metal. These are the steps, the major steps involved in the extraction and the purification of the metals. Now let us see what is given in your textbook exactly. I have reproduced here. These are the steps from ore to extraction based on the reactive nature, how the high reactive metals were, as they are in the form of halides and oxides. They are extracted through the electrolysis method, and moderately reactive metals are extracted when they are in the carbonate form or sulfide form. By means of chemical reaction, they are converted first into oxides, then they are reduced to the metals. This is all we have learned in our previous classes, and today we are going to learn this step, that is metals of low reactivity. Actually, metals of low reactivity are available in the nature in the form of sulfides, sulfide ores. Okay, then they are converted into oxides. If they are not in the form of oxides, they are first converted into oxides. If they are in sulfide form, first they have to be converted into oxide, then they are reduced to the metals. Like all the other metals, these metals also have to be purified. That is, they have to go under refining stage. Now, this is what yesterday we have in our previous class we have learned. Let us have a look at them. They are the middle reactive elements in the form of carbonates and sulfates. Roasting, we have converted them first into the oxides, then we reduced the oxides to get the metals. This is all about our previous class. Let us try to recall them. The important concept is roasting. In your examinations, so many times the question was repeated. This is all about our previous class. In our previous class, one important process we have learned, that is thermite welding or thermite process. This is also a very important one. It is a kind of displacement reaction. Student, now we are at the extraction of the low reactive metals. Aurum, that is gold, argentum, that is silver, platinum, and hydrargyrum, that is mercury, comes under low reactive metals. Actually, they are available in the nature, that is in the earth crust, in the form of oxides and sulfides. Now let us see how they are extracted. So extraction of the metals at the bottom of the activity series. Metals at the bottom of the activity series are often found in free state. Why? Because they are not so active like other metals. So they are unable to combine with other element to form a compound. That is why they are in the free state in the nature. Their reactivity with other atoms is very, very low. The oxides of these metals can be reduced to the metals by heating alone, because these metals have a very low melting point. On heating, immediately they turn into liquid form or in, to the vapor form. So that is why this method is adopted. And sometimes by the displacement of other aqueous solutions also. Now let us see, taking one example, how the silver is extracted. Silver is available in the nature in the form of sulfide, that is silver sulfide. The silver sulfide, when it is dissolved in the potassium cyanide solution, a reaction takes place and a complex compound is formed. Here you see, when the silver sulfide is dissolved in potassium cyanide, it reacts with cyanide ions and potassium ions, and the silver sulfide is also splits into silver ion and sulfide ion. A complex ion is formed, that is dicyanoargentate. It is dicyanoargentate, and sulfide is combines with potassium to form potassium sulfide. That is a different story. And this silver cyanide ion added to zinc powder, displacement reaction takes place, and a silver metal is obtained. In this way, we have extracted the low activity metals from their ores. Now, the refinement, that is purification of the metal. So far, in various tests, we have extracted a crude metal, not a pure metal. There is a slight difference between a crude metal and a pure metal. What is it? Even though we have surpassed so many steps to obtain a metal, there may be chances for some minerals still present in the ore, in the metal, in the form of impurities, or some other non-metals also present in the metal that we have extracted in various steps. To obtain a pure metal, we have to purify or refine the crude metal in various steps based on the nature of the metals. In your book, there are given four purification types. That is distillation, another one is tolling, and the liquation, the last one is electrolysis. Of course, there are some other methods also to obtain the metal. We have seen some various methods. The metal obtained by the reduction of the ore is usually contaminated with the impurities that are like unchanged ore. That is, still ore is present in the metal. Some other non-metals also present in the metal. So they have to be separated to obtain the pure metal. These are the other methods that have not given in your big textbook. Cupellation, fractional distillation, and thermal association also are there in purification of the metals. The process that has to be adapted for the purification of the given metals purely depends upon the nature of the metal and the nature of the impurities present in the extracted metal. Now let us see what are those one by one in this class. The first one is the distillation method. Now let us see what is meant by distillation and what type of metals are purified in this distillation method. As you know, some metals have a very low melting point and soon vaporize on heating at low temperatures, while other impurities remain in the state of solid state. Zinc, mercury, and arsenic are purified by this distillation method. The impurities have high boiling point, whereas the metal is low boiling point. When the crude metal is heated up, very soon the metal is vaporized. The extracted metal in the molten state is distilled to obtain the pure metal as a distillate. So this is the principle behind a distillation. Zinc, cadmium, arsenic, they form the vapor easily. The crude metal, when they are heated at a certain temperature, they start to vaporize, and after condensing this vapor, the pure metal is obtained in the molten state. What about the impurities? The impurities remain in the solid state and they are easily separated. So by this way of distillation, we purify the metals like zinc and mercury. Now let us go to the next purification method, refinement method, that is tolling. What is it? The metal is converted into molten state. then it is taken into a tub like thing, and it is stirred with logs of green wood. Okay, then what happens? The impurities are removed either as gases, or they get oxidized and form a layer called scum. It's a slag. The slag is removed over the surface from the surface of the molten metal, and the metal is purified. Blister copper, that is impure copper, is purified by this way. The reducing gases evolved from the wood prevent the oxidation of the copper. Sometimes the reactive metals, when purified, come into contact with the oxygen present in the atmosphere, forms again oxides. So it will be a waste one. So we have to prevent the oxidation of the such high reactive metals in the purification stage. So here the gases reduce the oxidation nature of the metals. Now let us get into the other purification method, that is liquation. In this method, a low melting metals like lead and tin, they are purified in the liquation method. Liquation, that tells us the process. Liquation, that means the metals are converted into liquid form, and they are made to flow on a slopy surface to separate it from high melting impurities. This liquation is generally done in the reverberatory furnace. The huge amount of heat is required for this, so this liquation method is done in the furnaces. So see, the liquation is being carried out here. The process is used for refining the easily fusible metals, like I told you, lead and tin. The impure metal is heated on the sloped hearth. This is the hearth, you see. It is a sloped surface of the reverberatory furnace. The metal easily melts, and the metal flows down in the molten form and collected here as a pure metal, whereas the impurities which are present in the crude metal, they stay behind here like this. These are purified. Okay children, so far we have covered three methods. The last one is electrolytic refining, that we will learn in our next class. Okay, so far we have seen the extraction of the metals at the bottom of the activity series, and the refinement of the metals. Now let us see how far we have learned in today's class. Try to answer these questions. What is the need to purify the crude metal? Why the metal needs to be purified or refined? And also try to answer the second question. Explain the extraction of the metals at the bottom of the activity series. Write down in detail note about the extraction of the metals at the bottom of the activity series. Mention two methods which produce very pure metals from their impure metals. Now choose the correct answer from the given options. The metal that occurs in the native form is A, lead, B, aurum, C, iron, D, mercury. Here you see There is a chance for two options also. Try to answer. Thank you very much for listening to my class. Thank you, one and all. We'll meet in the next class.